So, what laws do the governments and the mobile phone industry hide behind?
What usually happens, if they want to come and put a transmitter outside your house or on the corner of your road or somewhere, they will usually come along. They will usually say, "We follow the ICNIRP guidelines, which is the International Commission for Non-Ionizing Radiation Protection." They say, "We are well within the ICNIRP guidelines, we are well within the law. There is nothing you can do about this." Zonk, there it is, live with it. But in fact, they are lying. They are lying. I have travelled all over the UK and all over the world, and I have never yet met a single decision maker that has read the international certificate. Not one. And yet they will decide planning issues. You can see hospitals with transmitters above the maternity ward.
Yes.
I've never met a single person that has read it. Well, I have. And on page 546, it specifically says that decision makers should take special account of children, the elderly, the sick. It says that some people may be especially sensitive to microwave irradiation. So before any transmitter goes up, what they should really do is a survey of the area to find out how many children there are, how many pregnant ladies, how many elderly, how many sick, to find out whether they're going to affect them. And on the next page, it specifically says that decision makers should read current scientific literature, up-to-date scientific literature, and they should set an exposure standard which is below the threshold currently known to be causing illness from microwaves. What they will do is they will come along and they'll say, and I can guarantee what they have said, they will say, "These are radio waves, there's no problem, we've had radio for years, we're well within the ICNIRP guidelines." Zonk. And that is a lie. That is a lie. What they should show is evidence of looking at the population, evidence of reading, and why they set the level that they have set. But they don't. They set the maximum level, which is allowable within the International Commission's guidelines, and all of them are set usually to the maximum guidelines. Whereas, in fact, they should set a minuscule level if they have read the papers, and they should show evidence of reading. You're a doctor.
Yeah.
If I came to you and said, "Show me evidence of your research," you would show research papers, books, writings, calculations, and convince me that you knew what you were doing. And this is what the planners would do. And if they have lied, then there may be a good legal argument for having this transmitter taken down.
It's entirely obscene that they put these things on hospital roofs when the ICNIRP says the elderly and the sick can be affected.
They tend to target, and if you look at this, people will say I'm wrong, but I don't believe I am. Have a look where most of the transmitters are. They tend to be in areas where people need money. They will choose the poor areas around cities because they know that poor people do not have the means to take on the most powerful industry on the planet and fight them. Hospitals are desperate for cash because the government keeps them poor, so they go on hospital roofs. Schools are even more desperate for cash because the government keeps them poor. So you will get them in school playgrounds, because the industry will come along and say, this is safe, they're only radio waves, here's a nice check, zonk. Colleges will have them on the roof because they're poor. Universities will have them by the hundred because universities are desperately poor. So have a look and you will find that most of the transmitters are in areas where people are poor. You will be very hard pressed to find one in a wealthy person's garden.
What I wanted to ask you, Barrie, was who drew up ICNIRP and do they have any connections with the mobile phone industry?
There is a large body of government scientists, and if you look at the list, it's been published. There is a large body of the same scientists that sit on our government advisory panel, the International Commission panel, the World Health Organization panel. So it is largely the same scientists. And they have very bomb-proof qualifications. And when you have a Sir Professor standing up saying, I do not believe there is proof for this, that is all the councils need.
Yes.
You know, compared to somebody like me, that is all the councils need. And they will say, well, we'll go with Sir Professor. But you will find it has been published, but you will find the same names appearing on the same lists.
Thank you. So from a legal point of view, is there any way that people can have transmitters removed? Have you had any successes with having transmitters removed?
We have had successes with having them moved, and there are several legal arguments here, and I'm not trained in law, so I'm assuming that what I say is correct. There are a few legal arguments. Some of the decision makers say to the populations that they are not required to consider health in planning decisions, especially the UK. That contravenes the European law. There are two European laws which say health must be considered and it must be a major consideration. There is a United Nations law under the United Nations Charter, number 22, that says persons with disabilities, i.e. electrosensitivity, people who are sensitive to microwaves, they cannot be discriminated against. So if you go to a road and you go, zonk, there is a transmitter, I'm sorry that 300 of you, and it may not be 300, it may be the Irish Doctors Association, who are an incredibly clever and knowledgeable group of doctors, and are really tip-top when it comes to radiation. They believe it may be as high as 15 in 100. So when the industry puts up a transmitter and says, I'm sorry, you're electrosensitive, you're just going to have to suffer or move, under United Nations law, that is illegal. They cannot do that.